Leadership and Life with your host, Roberta Pickett.
Welcome back to Insights on Leadership and Life. Thanks for sticking with us. And my name is Roberta Pickett. I'm your host, and I'm here with Sandra Downes and Wayne Ricci. And we are talking about the challenges and fun of running small rural businesses. So I wanted to find out a little bit more about actually what you do within your businesses. So talk to me more, Sandra, about Pearls.
Okay, well, Pearls is a gourmet cafe, and it is strictly vegetarian. We do not have any animal products.
We thought you were going to go, there's no way you're going to survive on the mountain with vegetarian.
The mountain's always been meat and potatoes.
And it still is, with an option. There's an option there, you know, and that's Pearls, you know. There's a lot of great establishments up country that have those meat potatoes. And my husband studied health and nutrition. And when we got married and decided to have a family, we decided that we were going to change our diet from meat and potatoes. And I was raised in the country, farm girl. So I was a little hesitant. Ed was the mastermind behind changing our diets and raising our girls the way we raised them, a vegan. And they thank us every day for that. And so I think that's our drive, is that our girls were thankful for the way that we raised them. So we thought, well, maybe we can do that for a living. Mm-hmm. And what a wonderful feeling that would be able to cook and serve items that we've been eating for over 35 years. So we were very scared. We moved in not knowing anybody up country, and we soon met a lot of people, because it was a struggle to get it open. It took us 2 years to get open. But in that time, that 2 years, we made some friendships with people in the community, and they just absolutely supported us. Once we did disclose that it was going to be vegetarian, they absolutely thought, okay, well, we can't wait to see how. And us included, you know, we were thinking, okay, we're going to try it. You know, this is all we know.
Right.
This is all we know. You don't want us cooking your meat, because it wouldn't be to your satisfaction, Wayne. But so we started out with a small menu. We still have a small menu. And it, you know, the community is just awesome, very receptive.
How did you end up in Pioneer then?
Well, we searched, when we decided that we wanted to come back to Northern California from Missouri, we searched. We searched from Sebastopol. We thought that's where our little cafe was going to be. We went to Angel's Camp, Murphy's.
So you were actually looking at some of the smaller communities and not in the middle of a big metropolitan.
Right. No, we wanted to be up in the trees. We wanted to be in the coastal mountains. Sebastopol was beautiful. Mm-hmm. We love it over there. It just didn't work out for us. And we used to go up from Manteca and Escalon, where we used to live. We used to go up. We'd go take our girls to Indian Grinding Rock and little picnics.
Right.
And so we went up country quite a bit, because we wanted to get out of the valley and get up in the trees, the beautiful Sierras. So we were up there, and we'd go snow skiing before the girls were born. We would go up to Bear, to Kirkwood, and we'd go to Tahoe. So we knew how beautiful it was up there, but we didn't know how beautiful the people were. We didn't know that the community was going to accept us so welcoming. But with all the support that we got from our girls and our friends, And we just said, well, we're gonna give it our best shot and see what happens. And here we are, one year under our belt, and it's been wonderful. It's been absolutely wonderful. I think we really surprised a lot of people.
I think
including ourselves.
We get our veggie omelets, Tammy and I, all the time. It's great. I know. Hey, veggie omelet, Tammy. Extra salsa.
Yes.
Salsa.
I never forget the day my husband came home. He says, guess what I had for breakfast? I said, what? He said, vegetarian sausage.
I know.
And I said, and he said, I couldn't tell the difference. It's just nice. Like you said, you're giving people something different, a new option on the table.
Absolutely. And I think that a lot of people have, they just aren't knowledgeable about what vegetarian is. You know, one guy came in just the other day and he said, well, I was fishing with a guy, and he says, well, have you tried out that new vegetarian cafe? And he says, oh, that place where all they serve is tofu. And so I said, why do people? And then another customer says, they don't have cheese and eggs. You know, it's just, you know, nothing there. And so the guy that came in and said, all you serve is tofu, and he says, the menu has several things. So he ordered, I can't remember, breakfast burrito or what, and he said, my husband walked over to him and he says, well, how'd you like that tofu? And he said, I thought it was the best breakfast burrito I've ever had. And he goes, that's what we like to hear. That is success to us. You know, I know it's just, it just gives us so much pleasure when we get those type of compliments, mm-hmm. and people are so shocked. It's just amazing, you know, how surprised they are that it tastes. It has taste, I guess. Yeah. I don't know what they're expecting, yeah. other than, you know, 35 years ago when Ed and I first started this way of eating, it was a lot more difficult than
it is now.
Well,
you know, there is a lot more emphasis on what we eat these days, and I think that just even coming up with recipes that are flavorful, you know, lots of veggies, different veggies, and pulling them together, and to realize it is flavorful, it is delicious, and aside from being nutritious, so
right.
it's nice to see that, and it gives people another option to maybe try at home as well.
Right, and that's a lot of people asking for our recipes.
It doesn't mean you have to be vegetarian even all the time, but
no,
break
we
it up,
don't
you know?
Expect to change people's lifestyles, you know, and we don't want to do that. You know, we just want to give them another option, and this state has such wonderful produce. The vegetables and the fruits that we get right in our back door are just sitting there waiting for us to serve.
To
you
turn
know?
Into something wonderful.
Yes,
yeah.
yes. And so we just think that if people will just try it, and if they like it, then they'll return, and that's success to us. If they enjoy their visit with us, and our guests are so special to us because they're choosing us to come and spend their time and make memories. We have people bring their family members back and want to enjoy a good meal with their family and their children or their moms and dads, and so that's what our goal was to get that family feel and get some good healthy food and let them experience pearls.
Well, I think you really summed it up there, is that you brought all your values, your personal values, to the table, literally to the table, and you're sharing that with the community around you. And I think just as a community member, as a neighbor, I really see that we've embraced that. It's so nice to, I mean, we saw you working on the place for a long time before
yes.
you actually opened.
Yes.
And we were all curious, and we felt that as soon as we walked in. It's like, wow, these are good people.
Well, we made some lifelong friends opening this little shop. Like I said, we didn't know anybody up country. We have family and friends down in the valley in Manteca, Ripon, but we just feel like we have now family up country, because everybody that comes in, we try to treat them like family, because they are.
Yeah.
And it definitely has that feel when you walk in, because while you're cooking, you're chatting as it's like you're in, you know, someone's kitchen.
Just in
kitchen.
The kitchen, yeah.
So you have that conversation.
And that's worked out great because we don't have a kitchen, you know. So we're working right there behind the bar, and it's actually working out really well because we can chit-chat while we're cooking. And a couple times a customer will say, oh, don't forget, you're cooking an omelet over there. And so they remind us, you know, keep us on track.
You're talking too much.
Yes, you're talking too much, Sandra. Just, you know, you're cooking somebody's omelet over there. I'm glad it's not mine because I think you need to do something with it.
You never had to start over, have you?
No. Well, we had to start over because we had a lady that was allergic to garlic. And so we had cooked her an omelet. We don't put garlic in our omelets, but we have a seasoning that garlic is in the seasoning that we put in there, and so we got to reading the labels because it says, okay, we try to cater, we cook to order, so everything's up fresh and made to order, but I'm thinking we can't serve that. So we started over, and I said, okay, well, you know, leave off the seasoning.
Me, I'd ate it.
So
free.
Take this off our hands, Wayne. We've got an omelet over here.
Remember that. If you ever have to, just give them a call.
Well, and sometimes, you know, they order a veggie sandwich. Okay, so all of our sandwiches have veggies on them, of course. But, you know, they say, well, I ate it because I thought that was a veggie sandwich. And I says, well, that's a panini. And so, you know, we sometimes get a burger. Well, I ordered a burger, but I got a panini. I thought, well, if this is what you call a burger. And I says, well, who ordered the burger? And so sometimes it gets a little bit confusing for people that aren't used to ordering.
See, you're teaching us, you're educating us along the way, too.
And we're learning, too. You know, people just don't know exactly what it means that it's a veggie salad.
Well, we're going to thank you so much for that. We're going to come back in a few minutes after we take a quick commercial break.
Sorry.